This meeting today is taking place just before Minister Rabiah and myself will co-chair the Joint Economic Commission established between Saudi Arabia and South Africa that will take place tomorrow in Cape Town. And it will also be accompanying a meeting of the Joint Business Council. And I want to say that I don't think that we could proceed that important meeting, which we have been maintaining, I can say, a very strong discipline over during the last few years. We've been having that meeting regularly to try to pursue deeper economic relations between our two countries. We could not proceed that meeting better than by this event today, where we are commemorating the opening of the largest investment project by the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia in South Africa. That's one of the remarkable features about this particular project today. So this project is significant as a testimony to the growing investment relationship between our two countries. And that's been the role that our department has played. It's been to support the investment through Invest South Africa, which is the new division that has now been created, which is overseen by an interministerial committee led by the President, where we aim to provide a one-stop, seamless service to investors in all sectors of the economy. But it's also a tribute to the efforts led by the Department of Energy in the design and the rollout of the Renewable Energy Independent Power Producers Program. The Renewable Energy Power Producers Program was designed a few years ago as a way of bringing renewable energy to our country, principally solar power and wind power. Those are the principal sources of renewable energy that are most feasible here in South Africa. And the REIPP, I think, needs to be recognized and acknowledged for what it has achieved. It is and has supported by far the largest renewable energy program on the African continent. But it is also recognized as one of the best designed, best implemented renewable energy programs in the world. You heard Mr. Abu Nayan say it just now, so you don't have to take it from me. He said it was one of the two best programs that he was aware of, and I'm aware that's one of the top three programs in the world. So I think that that's one of the important things that we should acknowledge. It is, in fact, a program that provides certainty to investors. It shows investors what our ambitions are. It lays out the terms and conditions, and it has supported projects with a value of 194 billion rand of investment over the last few years. So it is a very, very significant program. This particular project that we are opening or commemorating today is a 5 billion rand investment, a joint venture investment between ACWA Power of Saudi Arabia and the partners from South Africa, who we heard explain to us that their involvement in the project was not just a passive shareholding involvement, but actually did provide a significant stake in the rollout of this particular project and program. And I think that their role in this also needs to be commemorated. This project will deliver 50 megawatts of power into the grid. And just to put that into some kind of a context, that is the equivalent of the supply of 21,000 households from this particular plant. It can supply the electricity needs equivalent of 21,000 households. It is a renewable energy project, which means that it is not using or producing or emitting into the atmosphere carbon. And in fact, its saving on carbon is equivalent to the release of 230,000 tons of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. So this project is saving the planet the equivalent of 230,000 tons of emissions of carbon dioxide. One of the features of this, which I think is innovative in the South African Renewable Energy Program, is this already been explained, this is a concentrated solar power project. And that means that it has a storage capacity, that it heats the liquid goes into the tanks are able to, the heat in the tanks through the transmission from one tank to another, as I understand it, is able to ensure that we have generation of power for 9 hours after the sun goes down. And that means that it has, as unique among the renewable energy projects, most of the renewable energy projects, they depend very much on the conditions, can generate power during daytime if they're solar, or if they're wind, they can generate power when the wind is high, but not when it's nighttime or when the wind is low. But this particular one has a storage capacity, and that makes it unique. And that means that it can continue to provide power during the nighttime peak, as we've already seen, and I think that makes this very, very significant. Another feature of this is that the project has supported a significant degree of localization. Throughout the construction of the project, 2.4 billion of the total investment of 5 billion were spent on locally procured projects. That's what I'm told. 40% of the plant was sourced and manufactured locally. That includes the manufacturing and assembly of the field collector and steel structures, the manufacturing and site erection, installation and testing of the relevant number of water storage reservoirs and tanks for the molten salts, the supply of piping and cables, site preparatory work such as earth moving foundation work, piling and ancillary service works, mechanical and electrical erection and assembly of turbine, heat exchangers, transformers, pumps, as well as piping and cable installations. Let me say that we have actually been discussing with ACWA Power that we would like to deepen the level of localization, and we'd like to move this whole area of localization much further forward. You probably know, many of you, certainly the Premier and the MECs, that in the context of the Special Economic Zone program, one of the potential special economic zones in the Northern Cape is a renewable energy special economic zone in the area from Upington roughly to DR, which would encompass a whole range of these projects and programs. Let me just say on that one that we are awaiting processes that would have to be completed to enable the board of the Special Economic Zones Advisory Board to make a recommendation. And I earnestly hope that the local stakeholders, the province, the municipalities, go through the processes of consultation, go through the processes of technical presentation that are required so that we can proclaim that SEZ as quickly as possible. Because I think that when we look at the figures, they tell us that most of the local content, most of the jobs are created during the construction phase, and I think it's very, very important that we don't lose out. So for example, as we've already heard, 1,200 people were employed at peak in the construction of this particular plant, and that also includes the people that were involved in the creation of the local products that went into this particular plant. When the plant is up and running and all the construction is finished, the numbers of permanent employees will go down to only 70. So the construction is very important. And in that regard, I'm very pleased that ACWA has indicated that there's another bigger plant, double this size, 100 megawatts, that they are involved in, and that would add to the capability and capacity. That one's got a different technology, quite an exciting technology, where the parabolas are aimed at a particular point up at the top of that tower that we saw in the picture. That's a new technology also that's coming to South Africa. But as I said, our ambition is to increase the level of localization. And that we've seen then as the different bid windows of the REIPP have unfolded, there has been an increase in the level of local content. For example, in the first bid window, the threshold for local content was only 25%. And in the fourth bidding round, it was specified that at least 40% of the project spend should be from local suppliers, with a target of actually 65%. So we're now beginning to see value chains created, and it's that particular piece of work that our department wants to work together with other stakeholders to ensure that that happens, in part through the special economic zones. When we've met during our various meetings of the Joint Economic Commission, Minister Rabiah and myself, we have been looking to identify and increase investments between our two countries, and we've been bringing business leaders together. And I want to congratulate the chair and the various members of the ACWA Power, Mr. Abu Nayan, and his team for the vision, for the foresight, for the confidence that they have had in investing in South Africa. And I think we've also heard one of the reasons why they will continue to work in South Africa is that when they have made an investment in South Africa, they've actually had a good experience. I think also they should be commended. They should be commended for recognizing the importance of working with communities, of drawing local communities in, and of accepting that corporate social responsibility is in fact an inextricable element of competitiveness of international businesses worldwide, including here in South Africa. South Africa is becoming a frontier for the renewable energy programs, but we're also going to be moving into other areas of energy. Oil and gas, the Premier mentioned some of the others, the oceans economy, rail among others. Our government has committed to spending 870 billion rand on investment in infrastructure over the next 3 years. And our track record in this regard is that we have actually managed to spend in the last five-year term of government that ended in 2014, 1 trillion rand on investment, which was more than double the amount that was spent in any other five-year term. It is, in fact, one of our major counter-cyclical initiatives, the infrastructure program, and we are committed to continuing with that. To our visitors from Saudi Arabia, I simply want to say that South Africa is indeed open for business. In fact, we're more open for business than we've been before, because Invest South Africa is here to help you to steer through any regulatory problems that you may have, and certainly to make it very clear to you what incentive programs, what support programs are on offer from various countries. South Africa offers a business environment which we believe is comparable to the highest standards of many developed countries indeed. We have one of the least restrictive jurisdictions in the world, and I trust that you will enjoy the rest of this program today and have an opportunity to look around this very exciting project, as I did myself a little while ago. And I also look forward to a very productive meeting of the Joint Economic Commission tomorrow, as well as a successful meeting of the Joint Business Council. As I said at the beginning, I don't think we can have a better way of introducing those two events. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.